Hey everyone, I'm Chaitanya and welcome back to the Ruvanchai channel. I hope you guys are doing well, and in today's session we'll be painting a scene of Northern Lights. This is also known as Aurora Borealis, and it's a magnificent phenomena that is seen near the north and the south pole of the earth, and this happens due to some kind of a reaction between the solar winds and the gaseous atmosphere around the earth. And you get to see these stunning green and pink and some few more shades of colors in the sky, and they assume these kind of beautiful patterns, sometimes a bit of a wispy cloud like shape or a stream like shape in the sky. And it's always fascinated me since the first time I read about them in an encyclopedia or something as a child. So I hope you guys enjoy watching it, and let's get started with it. I'm starting with these following colors on my palette: Prussian blue, cobalt teal, viridian green, cadmium yellow, magenta, mauve, and of course a bunch of white, because nothing is complete without that. To begin with, I'm going to start painting the dark night sky, and that I'm going to do with Prussian blue. And this is going to be painted in patches, so I'm going to be leaving out spaces for the streaks of light in the sky. To begin with the light streaks in the sky, I'm using cobalt teal here. Throughout this painting, you'll notice a lot of mixing of colors to get the right shades and a good transition. So as I'm painting the light streaks in cobalt teal, I'm also mixing the edges in the wet Prussian blue underneath, so that the transitions are not very harsh but kind of softened and smoothened. If I'm mixing two wet colors right on the canvas, then every now and then I'll wash my brush and dry it, and then pick the next color and then work on it, so that the mixing is appropriate and exactly how I want it, and no unwanted mixing happens, leading to some crazy color combinations. You must have just noticed me create a shade of green. I'm making that using teal, white, and a bit of yellow for the warmth. This shade I'll be using every now and then to add a bit of that bright green at the bottom of these auroras. Here I'm adding some more teal to help with the mixing of these colors. Now we'll be introducing a bit of magenta to the mix of colors here, especially for a particular part of these auroras, especially the tops of them. As long as the Prussian blue underneath is wet, we can easily blend this magenta into it and create a really nice and smooth transition. Every now and then I'll try and mix and blend the edges of these streaks so that they don't appear solid. Now I'm adding fresh layers of magenta, teal, and this green that we have made on the palette, so that they can mix gently and nicely together while they are wet on the canvas. I'll be using mauve on the magenta side of the streaks so that it blends nicely into the deep dark Prussian blue in the night sky. I'll be doing more of that back and forth with different colors all over again for every single streak. Now I'm going to paint the snow at the bottom of this landscape, and for that I'll be using a mix of Prussian blue and white. Now remember that viridian green that we took out on the palette earlier? Yes, so we'll be using that with a bit of white and tiny bit of yellow to create this distant aurora in the background. To complete this picture, I'll be using black to quickly paint a few trees on the horizon in the background. Now I'm going to quickly add a lot of stars in the sky so that they look scattered and random enough, but at the same time prominent. Now using white and a bit of Prussian blue, I'm going to add some snow to the treetops. Now to finish it off, I'm going to add a bit more brightness to the streaks using the brilliant green that we made on the palette, but with slightly more white to it. So that's how you paint the night sky of Northern Lights. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you're going to paint this, all the material that you'll require to do this will be mentioned down below in the video description. If you did like this video, do hit like, do subscribe to our channel, and see you very soon next time. Bye bye.